Hello and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Benjamin Damkroger and I'm a product marketing engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will take a closer look at shunt resistor tolerance error. In previous videos, we introduced the root sum of squares, or RSS, the total error equation for current sense amplifier circuits, as shown here. Note that not all error terms may be shown. The rest of this video focuses on shunt tolerance. Shunt tolerance is the only error term that has nothing to do with the current sense amplifier itself, but is a key contributor to the system error. Its effect on system performance bears the same characteristics of gain error on the current sense amplifier itself. Shunt resistor tolerance is defined by the shunt resistor manufacturer and can be found on the product data sheets for resistors. It is usually specified in percent. A 5% shunt can be up to 5% from its ideal value, directly contributing up to 5% error to the gain error of the system. Shunts with a tighter tolerance will contribute less error to the system with more predictability. Another thing to note about resistors is the temperature coefficient. This specification, often referred to as TEMPCO, describes the variance in the resistor over its standard operating temperature range. TEMPCO is usually reported in ppm per degree C. Divide this number by 10,000 to get the variation in percent per degree C. A TEMPCO of 100 can contribute an additional 0.5% error over a 50 degree change in temperature, whereas a TEMPCO of 10 would contribute significantly less at just 0.05% over the same 50 degree change. Shunt resistors often have high currents flowing through them or are near components on the board that generate heat, so be sure to keep this in mind when designing your system if you expect large temperature variations. The equation to calculate shunt tolerance error is shown here. It is simply the percent deviation of actual input shunt voltage from ideal shunt voltage. V-shunt ideal is the product of the load current and ideal shunt resistor value, ignoring the tolerance and temperature drift of the resistor itself. It turns out the error contribution due to shunt is equal to the total shunt tolerance. The total shunt tolerance includes the initial tolerance plus temperature drift when temperature effect needs to be considered. The total shunt tolerance is expressed in percent. Unless otherwise stated in this presentation, shunt tolerance and total shunt tolerance are interchangeable. In this example, we wish to measure a load current in the range of 1 to 20 amps. The shunt has the following specification: nominal resistance equal to 1 milliohm, initial tolerance equal to 1%, and temperature coefficient equal to 100 ppm. Using our shunt error equation, we calculate that the resulting error is 1.5%. How do we make it better and minimize this error? There are two possible ways to approach this. First, you can choose a high-performance shunt, which means choosing a shunt with low initial tolerance and low temperature coefficient. Second, you may take advantage of system calibration. Let's take the same example from the previous slide, but substitute the shunt with one that is much more accurate. Here, the initial shunt tolerance is 0.25%, and the temperature coefficient is 10 parts per million. As you can see, the resulting shunt error is only 0.3%. It should be noted that high-performance shunt resistors can be significantly more expensive. There are a variety of shunt resistors available for current sensing applications. The most common use cases involve low-resistance, low-tolerance, high-power resistors to handle tens of amps with little voltage drop from the supply. Larger resistors can give a better signal at the low end of the dynamic range, where offset error dominates, but smaller resistors can give less voltage drop and dissipate less power, often making them the better choice for applications measuring large current. See the other videos in this series for more help on selecting an appropriate shunt resistance. For resistors with Kelvin connection leads or atypical geometries, follow the manufacturer guidelines regarding layout. Sometimes these resistors have a tolerance based on where they were measured when they were fabricated and trimmed at the factory. If you don't follow their guidelines, you may end up well outside the stated tolerance of the resistor. See the other videos in this series for more help on shunt resistor layout. Let's take a minute to summarize what we learned in this video. First, shunt tolerance is specified by the resistor manufacturer. Secondly, shunt tolerance can be the dominant source of error in the circuit. Thirdly, the typical shunt resistor desired for current sensing is one that is low resistance, low tolerance, high power rating, and low inductance. And last but not least, always follow the resistor manufacturer's layout guidelines. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on CurrentSense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.